High noon, 25 degrees outside. Did I take a wrong turn getting to the lake today? Hey guys, what's up? So I woke up this morning, it was 16 degrees outside, which is freezing for Arkansas. So I decided to sleep in just a little bit and got here to the lake at like noon. It's still really cold out, but it's one of the few days I'm gonna have to fish over the next couple weeks, so I'm gonna try to make the most of it. So since I only have about 4 hours to fish today, I'm gonna follow up on one of the comments I got in my recent video and ask me to make a video on how I use my electronics to find fish. And so what I'm gonna do today is just go out on Lake Maumelle and graph around on some new spots and try to find some fish offshore with these graphs. So there probably won't be a lot of fish catches in this video, but hopefully I can show you a few tricks I use to find winter bass with my electronics. So I'll catch up with you guys again when I find something interesting. So I just found my first interesting spot here. It's actually a pile of natural timber laying on the bottom, and this looks like a great spot to find some winter bass. Okay, so here's an image of this spot using the side imaging or the side scan on my Humminbird unit. And before I get into what's actually down there, let me explain what this picture is actually showing us. So in the very center, you'll see that bright line, straight line, and that's actually the transducer of the boat. So right now in the top center of the screen, that's where the boat is right now. And everything below that is actually what we've scanned or driven over. And then next to that bright line in the center of the screen, you're gonna see some black space. And that's actually the water between the boat and the bottom of the lake. And so if you see anything in that black area, that's normally going to be fish or maybe like floating debris that's not on the bottom, but it's just in the middle of the water column between the boat and the bottom of the lake. And then everything else to the left and right side of that black space is actually gonna be what's on the bottom, and it's gonna scan out as far as you set the beam to go. So it could go 30 feet on each side, 60 feet on each side, 100 feet on each side, and you can set that on your unit. And right here you can actually see a bunch of fallen trees on the bottom. And it looks like they were maybe cut down before the lake was flooded and still left down there over the years. And you can also see this bright spot in the middle of the screen on the right side. And it's a lot brighter than the bottom on the top half and the bottom half of the screen. And that bright spot right there is actually hard bottom. Whenever you see a really bright image on side scan, it's gonna mean that there's rock or some sort of hard bottom down there, and that's the kind of places fish love in the wintertime. And then if we zoom in on the spot, you can actually see some fish suspended over some of these fallen trees, and you can tell that there's fish there by looking for little dots that are separated from the bottom or the cover on the bottom, like trees and rocks. And so if you look at these little dots here, you can see they're not connected to any of the trees or any of the fallen limbs down on the bottom. And so if you see those little dots separated from the cover, those are gonna be your fish. And then here's a look at the spot using the down scan on my Humminbird. And again, let me explain what this picture's showing. So in this case, the boat is actually gonna be in the top right corner of the screen. And then everything to the left of that and below is actually gonna be what we've just scanned over. And right here is where the bottom of the lake is. And then everything above that is going to be the water between the boat and the bottom. And then everything below that is just kind of interference. So don't really worry about that on down scan. But again, we can see some nice trees on the bottom here, and you can actually see an elevation change really well here. It goes from about 25 feet up to 20 feet on this little hump, or I call them high spots. And you can see on the top of that high spot, it's really bright on the down scan. And again, that's going to indicate hard bottom or rock. And fish like hard bottom and rock in the wintertime because it holds heat and it's going to attract bait fish and crawfish. And then here's a look at this spot using the traditional 2D sonar, which is what most of y'all are probably familiar with. And so again, the boat is in the top right corner of the screen, and everything down to the left is going to be what we just scanned over. And then that thick bar in the center of the screen, that's going to be the actual bottom of the lake. And then everything above that in that white space is going to be the water between your boat and the bottom of the lake. And then everything below that is going to be extra data, and I'll talk about that here in a second.
But before we get to that, again, if you look at the middle bar again, which is the actual bottom of the lake, you can see a bunch of brush and timber down there. And it's a little bit harder to see than on the down scan. And sometimes it's kind of hard to tell if it's fish or brush on the bottom. So that's why I like to use both. And you can also see that high spot, that little elevation change in the center of the screen here. And you can actually tell that there's hard bottom on this on 2D sonar, just like you did on the down scan. And what you'd look for is that thick red line on the bottom. The top half of that bar, you see a thick red line. That's going to indicate hard bottom. If you look at the left and the right sides of the screen, the red isn't as thick as it is right on that top of that high spot or the elevation change. So when you're looking for hard bottom on 2D sonar, look for that thick red line, and that's where you're going to find it. And then getting back to that green blotch in the lower third of the screen, remember I said that was extra data? And basically what it is when the transducer pings twice. And I'm not going to get into what that means right now, but basically whenever you see that, it's going to mean that there's hard bottom in that area. So if you notice on the right and the left sides of the screen on the lower third, there's really not anything in that white space, just kind of like some little blue cloudy marks, but then there's a nice thick green blotch in the center, and it's right in line with that hard spot that I said had hard bottom as well, just above it. And so whenever you see that second kind of green blotch on the lower third of your screen, that's gonna mean there's hard bottom there. And then here's a look at this spot using Navionics or a topographic map. And I'm not going to get into how to read these topographic maps in this video, otherwise it would be like 30 or 40 minutes long, but I'm going to make a separate video on how to do that, and it'll hopefully be coming out next week. But just for those who are curious, this is what the spot looks like, and right here is where all those fallen trees were. And then you can see this little red spot here. I marked that point, or that high spot where we saw the hard bottom, and you can actually see it on the Navionics here. You can see that little point made by the contour lines, and this is a great spot to catch winter bass on Lake Maumelle.
Wow, but there's a ton of it down there. I don't know if I'll be able to cover all this in 4 hours, so I'm probably going to leave this for another day, but it's definitely a spot to check out in the future. And when you're graphing over these structure spots, try to keep your boat speed around 3 to 4 miles an hour. If you're going too slow, the side scan and down scan image is gonna be a little bit blurry. And if you're going too fast, it'll just wash away the transducer from all the wakes in the back of the boat. So 3 to 4 miles an hour is a good pace to go. So when I'm graphing offshore, this is the setup I use in my graph. I'll have side scan on the full left side of the screen, and that lets me see the brush piles and rock piles a little bit easier with that side scan. And I'll have the Navionics mapping in the top right corner, and then the bottom right corner I'll have 2D sonar. And then if I see something interesting like that little ledge right there, what I'll actually do is switch over to my view over here that has down scan and 2D sonar on top of each other. And I like that down scan because it really helps you pick out what's brush and what's fish. And so normally I'll just use those two views when I'm looking at offshore structure.
And to show you guys why I think it's important to graph offshore and understand how to use your electronics, here's a fish I caught a few years back offshore on Lake Maumelle, and it's the biggest bass I've ever caught out here. And I found it by graphing offshore on a roadbed, and it took me about 3 or 4 hours of graphing to find this spot. But if you put the time in and you learn to understand these electronics, you can find some big bass.
Here's another good looking spot. I can actually see some fish down here on the graph.
Okay, so here's the next spot I want to show you guys, and this time I'm going to show you the Navionics first, just so that you guys can kind of get a better idea of what the spot looks like before I actually show you the images on my Humminbird. And so right here we have a nice ridge that runs into the center of Lake Maumelle, and there's a nice creek channel that runs right across the tip of this ridge. So now here's a look at this spot using the side scan on my Humminbird, and before I actually got to the spot that I wanted to show y'all, I saw these little depressions or little craters on the bottom on the right side of the screen, and those are actually bluegill beds. Whenever you see something that looks like this on your side scan, those are going to be places where bluegill actually spawn. And this is a great place to catch fish and big bass in the summertime, because the big bass will get up on this ridge and they'll actually feed on those bluegill. So whenever you see those little craters or depressions, mark them on your side scan and come back and fish them in the summertime, and you're going to catch some big bass. Okay, so here's the spot I actually wanted to show you, and if you look on the right side of the screen, you can see another black blotch. And remember I said that black area in the center of the screen is the area between your boat and the bottom of the lake? Well, this black area on the right side of the screen is actually a shadow created by the creek channel ledge. So basically what that means is this is the top of that ridge, and it's in about 15 feet of water. And then where that black blotch is on the right side of the screen, that's the center of the creek channel I showed you on Navionics. And it's about 45 feet deep, right where that black blotch is. And basically what happens, I don't want to get into it too much because it's kind of hard to explain in this short video, but what happens is this transducer is going to shoot a beam across the bottom, and it's going to create a shadow right where that ledge is. The ledge is basically where the bottom goes from 15 feet to 45 feet really fast, and so right on that ledge is going to create that shadow. So to illustrate what I'm talking about here, I found this picture of this big shadow created by this rock. And to understand how this transducer shadow works, just imagine that the sun is the transducer, and that the sun's rays are like the transducer's beam. And anywhere where the sun doesn't hit, like the area behind this rock, is going to create a shadow. And the same thing is true with the transducer. Anywhere the transducer's beam can't hit, it's going to create a shadow. And the only thing that can be in that shadow is fish or debris floating in the water. So if we zoom into this ledge right here, you can actually see some white dots. They're sitting right on the break between that ridge in 15 feet of water and the creek channel in 45 feet of water. And because it's a shadow there, the only thing that can show up in that black spot is fish. And so what this means right here is that the fish are actually suspended off of the drop. They're not sitting up on top of the ridge, they're actually sitting in the middle of the creek channel, suspended, maybe in 10 or 15 feet of water, over 45 feet of water. And normally when I see this, this means the fish are inactive and they're not wanting to bite. That's probably why I didn't catch any fish here. But look out for that when you're graphing with SideScan. If you ever see white dots in like a black shadow, that's gonna be fish. Okay, so hopefully at least some of that made sense. But here's a look at this spot now using the DownScan on my Humminbird. And right here is the top of that ridge or that little ledge, and you actually don't see anything on the top of that ridge. There's no dots, there's no brush, nothing. And again, like we just saw, all the fish are actually suspended out in the middle of the creek channel. This is the creek channel right here, and they're all suspended out over the top of this creek channel, and no fish are up on top of that ridge. And normally when fish are actively feeding, you actually see them on top of that ridge. And here's an image from my Humminbird from the summer where I actually found a big school of bass that were on top of a ledge and they were actively feeding. And you can see all the little dots sitting on top of the drop, and then it drops off into deeper water. So this is the top of the ledge, this is the creek channel. And whenever the fish are up on top of the ledges or on top of the ridges, that's when you know they're going to be active. If they're in the creek channel or suspended over the creek channel, they're going to be inactive, and it's pretty tough to get them to bite. Okay, so hopefully tie it all together. Here's this ridge again on Navionics. The red area is the actual ridge. It's like 15 feet of water. The blue area is the creek channel. It's about 45 feet deep. And then you can see those little bluegill there. That's where that bluegill bed was. And whenever I'm graphing offshore structure, what I like to do is actually drive my boat right on the edge of the creek channel and the ridge, right where that break is. And the reason I do that is so that I can actually see fish up on top of the ridge, like I showed in that last image on my down scan. I can see if there's fish actively feeding on top of the drop. And I can also scan out to the side and see if there's any fish suspended over the creek, like that other image I showed you on the side scan. So I can both scan the top of the ledge and off the side of the ledge at the same time. So whenever you're graphing offshore structure, try to drive right along the edge of that creek channel, and you're gonna find more fish. Well, this has been a little bit harder than I was expecting to explain how I use my electronics to find fish. There's a lot going into it. So to kind of take a little bit of a break, I want to show you guys some cool images from some underwater bridges and roadbeds on Lake Maumelle. And right here you can see a nice road and an actual bridge that runs in the middle of the lake here. And then I took this other image that's actually really cool. It's like the top of that bridge, and you can see the actual graded fence on the top of that bridge using the down scan. And I thought that was just a really cool image that y'all might like. Okay, so here's another spot that I graphed over and that I wanted to show you guys. And again, I'm not going to get into the Navionics too much today. I'll talk about topo maps again in another video. But as you can see, here's a nice little creek channel that runs against this bank here. And the creek channel is about 45 feet deep. And then right here, there's actually a nice little high spot. You can see the contour lines get really close together in like a circle, and they come up to some shallow water, and there's some good rock on top of this high spot, and it's been a great place for me over the winters on Lake Maumelle to catch some big bass. So here's a look at this spot using the side scan on my Humminbird. And again, you can see some nice shadows on the right side of the screen here. And these shadows aren't just thrown off by like creek channel ledges. They're actually created by rocks, by big boulders, trees, things like that as well. And normally the length of the shadow depends on how tall the object is in the water. So if you have a big rock that's 10 feet tall in the water and it's sitting in 20 feet of water, that shadow is going to be 10 feet long on the screen. And so you can normally tell how tall a piece of cover is by how long that shadow is. And again, you can see fish in the shadows of like rocks and trees, and you can tell if there's fish there by looking at those shadows. So if we zoom into this spot on the right side of the screen, you can see there's a big shadow created by a giant boulder that's down here on the bottom. And you can see a ton of white dots in that shadow. Those are all fish. And so you want to be looking at these black spots on your side scan, these black areas, and looking for these little tiny dots on the screen. Those are going to be fish. I don't think these are bass. These are probably crappie right here. But either way, if you look for this, you're going to find bass eventually. Okay, so I've already shared a ton of information in this video, but I want to show you guys how I changed the settings on my graph to help get a better picture on my Humminbird unit. So first up, I'm going to change the sensitivity, and on this software here, it's called brightness, but on your graph, it'll be called sensitivity. And normally the stock sensitivity on a Humminbird unit is 10 out of 20. And if you turn that sensitivity up from, let's say, 10 to 15, it's going to make the image really bright. And any hard bottom like a rock or like a concrete area is going to stand out and be super bright. And then if you turn the sensitivity down from 10 down to, let's say, 5 out of 20, then it's going to make the image really dark. And this is really good when you're fishing, again, in those really rocky lakes. Sometimes you might want to turn that sensitivity down from like 10 down to 8 if the returns are really strong and it's just really bright. And then if the lake has a really muddy bottom or there's not a lot of hard bottom, you might want to turn up that sensitivity to maybe 11 or 12 just to maybe make the stumps and the logs stick out a little bit better and make the image a little bit clearer. And then you can also change the contrast on the Humminbird unit, and the contrast is kind of like how sharp or hazy the image is. And so if you turn contrast up, it makes the image really sharp and it makes it a little bit darker. And then if you turn the contrast down, it'll make it kind of hazy and fuzzy and not as clear. And so normally I keep my contrast around 9, 10, or 11, and I'll just kind of adjust it depending on what the image looks like, but I'll normally either use 9, 10, or 11 on contrast. So there are two settings I mess with on my Humminbird are sharpness and range. And so I'll start with talking about range. Range is on the side scan, how far the beam shoots out on both sides of the boat. So it'll either shoot out like 100 feet on both sides, 50 feet on both sides, 200 feet on both sides. And the general rule of thumb for me is that when I'm looking for fish on my graph, I like to keep the range between 60 and 90 feet, because anything wider than that and you're not going to be able to see the fish on the bottom. And then if I'm just scanning for like rock or for brush, I'll put that range all the way out to like 200. But if you want to go with just a basic setting that's going to get most of the job done, I would put around like 85 is a solid range on your side scan. And then as far as the range goes on your down scan, your 2D sonar, normally it's going to be set to auto again. It'll just adjust by the depth of water you're in. But normally what I like to do is set the range for my downscan and my 2D sonar to be twice the distance of the deepest structure I'm going to fish that day. So if I plan on fishing, the deepest spot I'm going to be fishing is going to be 20 feet of water, I'll set the range to be 40 feet. If I think the deepest spot I'm going to fish is in 40 feet of water, I'll set the range to 80 feet. And this lets you see that double return, so you can see if there's hard bottom down there, and it just kind of gives you enough room to see what's going on the screen. And then as far as a sharpness setting goes, you can turn this on and off on the Humminbird unit. And I like to set it on, and I set it to medium. I've messed around with low and high, and I just think the image looks really bad on both of those. When I first got my unit, I actually had sharpness off, and I thought that the image was terrible. I was really disappointed with my graph. But when I turned it to medium, it gives a really clear image, and you can see the images are really great on my Onyx 10. So if you're using Humminbird, just set sharpness to medium, and you're going to be all set. Okay, there's one more thing I gotta show you on side scan and down scan before we go. It would be a crime not to show you what brush piles look like on your sonar. And so right here is an image of a big brush pile on the side scan of my Humminbird. And you can see that there's just a bunch of nice limbs and branches down there that create this brush pile. And then on the down scan, you can actually see the tree really clearly, and it's sitting down there in about 25 feet of water. And then if you look at this brush pile and look at the black space above the brush pile, you can see there's no little dots or clouds of bait in that black area. There's literally nothing there. And that normally means there's no fish in this brush pile. And here's an image from a brush pile where I actually caught a bunch of fish this summer. And if you look at this one, you can see that there's tons of little dots in and around that brush pile. And those are actually bass. And I sat and caught maybe 30 or 40 fish off this one brush pile this summer. So this is how you figure out if there's fish in the brush pile. And normally I'll just graph over brush with my down scan and look for fish before I fish them. And that just makes you a lot more efficient in the summertime and in the winter when you're fishing offshore brush.
Hey guys, so if you're still here at the end of this video, then you're definitely a bass fishing addict like I am. And I actually had a lot of other stuff I was going to put in this video. I had some fish catches, some stuff with the Ned rig, and I'll probably put that in another video some other time, but I kept y'all long enough. So either way, I hope y'all enjoyed this video and learned something about how to use your electronics to find fish. And if you did, hit like and subscribe down below and leave any comments if you have questions about what I was doing. I covered a ton of material, so definitely let me know if I need to explain something again. And other than that, if you like this video, also share it with a friend who might want to learn how to use their electronics just a little bit better. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.